be that they just do this.
Right.
You know?
Exactly.
If a car drove past, which that is a working street, as the light hits that mirror, it bounces everywhere.
Yeah.
Brian and I were in the dining room trying to debunk the claims of people seeing faces in the mirrors and seeing apparitions. And then we noticed that as the cars came down the drive, when their headlights went through the window, it would hit the mirrors and cast glows and shadows and all kinds of stuff all over all the walls. A car can come right up that road right there, catch the headlights high. Look, it's bouncing left.
Yep.
You see it in that mirror over there?
Yep.
Look, it could be playing off all these mirrors. Look it.
Mm-hmm.
I hit that mirror, you're getting lights over there. This mirror right here is reflecting right there, and off the sides, and out that mirror.
Yeah, you're getting them all over the place.
It's important to bring Donna on these cases, not only to help the client as a good investigator, but because Donna at one time was a client, and she had questions that need to be answered. And a lot of her experiences started in Salem. So to bring her back 20 years later, hopefully we can get some kind of answers now.
I know that the experience you had up here impacted you, but I don't know that it was necessarily the one that impacted you the most.
No,
what was
definitely
the one?
Not. I was in fourth grade. I sat down to write a short story. That was one of our homework assignments. And I remember sitting down to write that story one day, and the pencil was just flowing. The words that were coming out in the paper weren't my words. I had to look a few of them up because I didn't understand.
Grant's like a mentor to me. When I first came into the group, you know, we spent hours on the phone talking about my experiences and his knowledge from what he had learned so far about the field. And I feel totally at ease walking into kind of the, you know, the darkness with him.
Hey, Lisa.
Hey, guys.
What up? Grant just called it. We're gonna wrap up. We're gonna head in, we can start wrapping up wires with them. I'll break down the van and call it a night.
Despite the fact that poor Jay has to deal with his poor son and his broken arm, I think we had a good investigation. I think the place was covered well. We just gotta watch the evidence and see what we caught. Hey, Robin.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good, good.
We're all wrapped up, ready to get out of here. We're just gonna review all the evidence we've captured and come back and tell you what we found.
All right, definitely let me know, and thank you guys so much. I so appreciate it.
Thank you, cool. Get some sleep, okay?
All right, take care.
One of my sons was playing today and ended up getting knocked down by his brother off the swing set. He ended up falling and breaking his arm pretty severely in two different places. It's been a pretty long night already, and I think it's going to be an even longer night. Right now, they're going to try to realign it, but they're really not sure if that's going to work. They might end up having to do surgery on it. And, you know, you got to take it as it comes, I guess.
Hey, Steve. It's the veritable cornucopia of evidence.
You know, we watched everything. We watched, of course, the DVR and all the mini DVs, the thermal. We didn't come up with anything hardcore, unfortunately.
Right. Jay really needed to take some time to be there for his son, so I'm going to be handling the cases up in Salem solo. And then once Brian and Steve are done with the evidence, I'm going to bring Steve back with me to talk to the client. There was one kind of weird experience Lisa and I had down at the bar. We're sitting here, and all of a sudden I noticed this computer screen turn on at 1:13. And Lisa said that she had noticed the computer screen turn on, but I found out later she's talking about another one up there.
Really?
So two screens turned on at the same time. And Lisa at that time was doing EVP work, and she asked, hey, if you're here, can you manipulate stuff? And as soon as she said that, the printer by one of the monitors printed up a receipt. And I grabbed it, and here's what it says.
Good morning. That's awesome.
126, good morning. I think pretty much what we have to do is go there, show the receipt, ask her if this has happened before, or what this could mean.
Okay.
And then we can really gauge whether it's paranormal or not.
Right.
If you don't mind, you want to come up and do the reveal? Because Jay's still occupied with his son.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
That would help
sure.
you.
No problem.
Cool, guys. Yeah. Well, great work, great
okay.
work.
Yep.
Awesome.
Okay.
Right, cool, thanks.
See you later.
How you doing, Robin?
I'm great, thank you. Hi.
Well, you know what we did. We came in here. We set up everything from infrared cameras, thermal imaging cameras, audio equipment, and you know, we were looking for the things that you described to us.
One other thing you had said is that a lot of people experience seeing an apparition in the mirror upstairs. If you look at the mirror, there's actually some scratches and some smears and some uneven surface on the mirror. So I think that combined with you know, your mind kind of playing tricks on you, and a phenomena that we call matrixing, you may see a face or an image in there that really isn't there.
Jason and I were walking through the kitchen area. We smelled what smelled to me like apple blossom.
Yeah.
And realized that there's like almost a janitorial type closet there with cleaning supplies.
Mm-hmm.
And that smell can easily go very far.
Okay.
So you could be maybe down here and somehow the draft brings that smell to you here.
Right.
Now, as far as the actual evidence goes, the concrete hardcore evidence, for the video and audio, we weren't able to catch anything that we couldn't explain away.
Okay.
But we did have a personal experience that night. It was namely in the bar area. And you've got two touchscreen point of sale systems up there.
Right.
And both screens just turned on by themselves, okay?
Mm-hmm.
At that time, Lisa was doing some EVP work. She was asking a lot of questions, you know? Show us, if you're here, manipulate some of this equipment. And right as she said that, one of the printers printed up a receipt.